Okay, welcome to Steve's shed, Scale Models. I've been doing some changing in the shed, and I've got to change around. So I'm going to take you in and show you around. So you've got just to come in. And here we go, this is the new area. Right, so yeah, this is the new shed area. I've pulled everything out and painted all the walls white, just to make it a little bit lighter and brighter. It just had to change things around. So the original bench area was all here, but I've just changed it all around. So now we've got the unit here. The lights on. It's just a few little cheapo LED lights from IKEA, which we've had before. So we've got a printer, manuals for the Mustang, and just a bit of literature. And then it's a bit of a storage area. Some bits of the house in there. And then just here we've got all my issues, future build issues for my last thing as well. And then up just some storage. And we've got some more shelves down here, drawers. At the moment I've just got some sprue stuff, all the extra sprues when I've done all my Bandai kits. Not quite sure what I'm going to do them yet. I need to sort through them, see if there's any bits, parts I might need. Then in here I've just got some scenic materials when I used to do the model railway in. And the rest of the rest are all sprues. And then down the bottom there is my box on the drone. So this is the new actual area. Spray booth there. That's a lot wider space, all on one level. I can sit down nicely. And I've got my laptop there, which is I can use just for viewing stuff and whatever, or getting computer work. More storage area for modelling. I've got in here my knives and some screwdrivers. Like I say, in there all my knives, pliers and tweezers. Then I've got some files, more filing stuff, and then some duct tape box for when I do my wiring. And my brushes. I've made this paint rack myself. It's brilliant, it's there, but it's okay, it does work. So you can see I've got my Tamiya paints on there. So yeah, I've got a few Tamiya paints. I know I've got loads, a lot of people have got shed loads more than what I've got. Then I've got my Revel paints, and I've got some let me just turn that light off, a bit bright glaring. Some of the Tamiya webbing masters. Some rail match pens, paints even, from when I used to do railway stuff again. And then some Humbrol washes and powders. And then just some empty bottles, some tape, some on the micro set and everything as well. And then some Tamiya glue. And there's a few clamps up there as well. Down the bottom here, got my iPad. Again, just for viewing stuff on and also playing music, because I have it attached to my amp, which is at the top there, and then playing out the speakers. Then we've got here, at the moment I've only got a couple, or three, is the Ultimate Primers, UMP, that's the white. From what I've only used the grey so far, and very good, dries very quickly. So I'm pleased with that so far. I haven't used the white or the black yet, I hadn't had a reason to use them just yet, but I bought them as a pack. It was cheaper to do that way. And here, just pots of odds and sods again. These are the Ultimate sanding sticks. The black one, they come in various grades. And then there's also one which is a polisher. Again, so far, very, very good product so far. I've not had any issues with them. And I think they're very well. I've just ordered some skinny sticks of the same thing. So, yeah. That's be good. Then next to them we've got the which is an aqua thinner, aqua revel thinner for the aqua paints up there. I've also got the airbrush thinner. This is supposed to be very universal. I haven't used it as yet because I'm still using, let me get that out of the way, I'm still using my Tamiya X20. There's still quite a bit in there to use yet, but I have been told that the Ultimate airbrush thinner is very, very good. It's a very good universal one. Can be used on with all the paint, well, not all the paints perhaps, but many, many paints. But on the side there is just a chart of what you can and can't use it with, well, what you can use it is, and what the ratio is. Down before, now I don't know if anybody remembers, but on my old paint area, I had this, and then all the Tamiya paints were on top of here. But I've just deconstructed that, and I've used all these drawers now for which for my like Humble paints, the old Airfix ones, etc. That one's empty, some more paints in that one. This one just on my for the paint. God, I forgot the cushion. One's gone. And then on my clips. None in here attached to sticks at the moment because they're all being used on a model I'm currently building. On top of there, got a set of extra hands, Tamiya spray paint, this is the pearl white. And that's going to be for when I do my Enterprise 1350. I think I need to get some more there because there's no way that can is going to be enough, obviously. And then there is the Enterprise. Not currently on building at the moment. Taking a break from it. Was finding it a bit, not stressful, but a bit like, this is a bit too much. So I'm just taking a break. Going to come back to it in a bit. I'm just building another kit at the moment. And then we're going to probably try back into it and getting, we need to do the electrics on the upper saucer, the saucer section, shall I say. Moving around, so I've got two lights, not great like that one, but it works. Then I've got the white light there, or the daylight, as they call it. A set of drawer or units, which used to be in the old one as well. All various different, I'm not going to go through all that lot because there's just too much to go through. Let's just roll that out of the way. Got up there my kitchen paper just for drying down and bits and pieces. Then I've got this, found this, scrapped. So I'll put it on the wall there and it just holds all my sprues that I'm not using and instructions and bits and pieces there as well. So yeah, I thought that was quite good there. Here my soldering iron, etc. Another set of hands and then my PowerPoint, well, not PowerPoint, but power supply for when doing my wiring electrics. Around here then, the Mustang, it's the 1/8 scale GT500 Ford Shelby Mustang, which has been, I'm halfway through at the moment, I've just done issue 50. So we're starting on 51 next, obviously, comes afterwards. Just in the bottom here, I've got my Dremel tool, it's not a Dremel, but it's just another version, my glue gun. And then here is my spray booth. So as you can see now, I've got all my clips on. This is all doing this is for my Batmobile, which I'm currently building. I'm not doing a really series on this one because I just needed something just to get back into the hobby again. I took some time out. Two airbrushes here. They're cheap ones. I'm having some issues with them, but I'm getting there with them. I'm going to try and save up for an Apex airbrush because I have been told they are very, very good, very reliable, and a very good all-round airbrush. Then obviously my cleaning bottles, just some bits and pieces there, some R2 railway, engine, Star Wars tin, bit of Doctor Who stuff. Then on top I've got my drone, which I use quite a bit, and then this is just a shelf where I keep stuff that's in the process of being built, or so as you can see, I've got, this is the base for the Enterprise, this is the shuttle base for the Enterprise, which we would have seen in the previous videos or that have been done before, and then that's a Arboretum. This is parts for a 124 scale Airfix submarine. That is a kit. Very lot of issues with it. It just doesn't really want to go together well. Was warned about it, so sort of started messing around with it. But Yeah, so it's just on hold. That's just up there, sitting up there. Because also I need to get some interior green to do that bit. So this is what I'm currently building. This is the Batmobile. I've sprayed this in UMP primer with the grey primer, and then I've mixed a combination of Tamiya black and Tamiya gun metal. It looks like the gun metal has come through more than the black, so it's a fairly nice colour finish. But referring back to pictures from the film, it does need to be black, so I might have to go over that again. And what else have we got? And then we've obviously got more drawers left on this side. Booze rack, more booze. Freezer, freezers, and before, but they were stacked on top of each other. So, most important shelf on there is the old Stella. underneath the airbrush, underneath where the spray booth is, I've got my pump. Compressor, sorry. I'm losing the ball. I've got the compressor under there, and then just some bits of cleaning stuff as well. And then there's just a space under there not being used at the moment. I'm sure I'll get to use that at some point. On this side of the bench area, we've got our first drawer. In here, just got some more parts of airbrushes, blades for the knives, craft knives, and spare lenses for my magnifiers. And then some bits and pieces in there as well. There's a couple of old airbrushes in there, which are totally kaput. Second drawer, more sort of just some clothes clips just for clamping, and some bits of wire, and there's an alarm system which I need to put into the shed at some point. I'm not using it at the moment, but underneath here I've got a radiator. And then under here, I don't have a big stash of kits. I really don't. It's just really can't afford to buy a lot of stash of kits, so I'm just buying what I wanted to buy and what I wanted to build, not just buying stuff on a whim. So we've got the 1350 Star Trek Enterprise, two Batmobiles there, and the Batpod, which I have built. Don't worry about this. It's just another projector. And then over here, we've got the Batman vs Superman Batmobile, and I've got another Batmobile from the original, but that one I've bought off eBay, and I looked at it about a month or so ago now. I've had it for nearly a year, and it's missing all the chrome parts. If anybody's got an idea where I can get chrome parts from for that, that would be great. I'm a bit peed off about that, and I can't contact the seller anymore because he's long gone. Typical. We've got an FX HMS Ark Royal. This is a nephew of mine. He started it, but then he's 8 years old and he's couldn't get into it. The parts are very small for him, and so he sort of like ruined it. Well, not ruined it, but lost interest in it, and so he's lost all parts, or lost some bits and pieces. So I said I'll take it off him and see if I can do something with it. No instructions, so I've got to go from there, nothing. Then I've got my next Star Trek Enterprise from the JJ Prize, as we call them. And then we've got the box for that submarine Spitfire 124 scale. that's all my kits at the moment. Bit more of my bench area. What I have done is I've got a camera up here, which then means that I can then show screenshots of coming down. Which is what I want to be able to do when I'm doing my filming. So I will have my camera hopefully set up for about here, so you can see what I'm doing, and then I can also use the shots coming down there. So yeah, that's my man cave, or what you want to call it, done. It's just 1 second. So yeah, hopefully that's been nice, maybe, I don't know. I know there's better man caves out there than mine, and this is just mine. This is my modelling area. Hopefully, now that I've done this, I'm feeling a bit more motivated to get back into it, because I've got a nice area.
nice chair to sit at. I've got plenty of leg room underneath so I can sit down and relax, put my legs out. Before, on the old one, I couldn't. I was all hunched up. The chair was a bit manky. Well, not manky, but it just wasn't a very good chair to be set up for any length of time. So yeah, that's my motivation for doing this. The white paint makes it all look a lot brighter and lighter in here, especially in the summer daytimes. It has been quite warm in here. But I've got my fans in here. Another thing that I'm sometimes known for, we've got on here these lights which I've put in. And I used to be probably on and still sometimes, so I'll just turn these off. One second. I'm sometimes known, referred to as a disco Steve on the ISM website and on the live hangout, and this is probably why, because I have all the my lights on, and I don't always do them flashing, but they like to just call me disco Steve sometimes. It's just a bit of a gimmick. Yeah, I don't always have it or it is at all. I tend to have it normally just on plain white lights. You probably can't really see me at all now. It's probably a good thing. Anyway, so let's just turn them on and just put them on white. Also just turn it, because that is washing me out, isn't it? There you go. So yeah, that's, I say, that's my tour of my cave. I'm quite happy here. This piece of it, and I hope we get to get some decent modelling done. Definitely, I'm going to get this Batmobile finished, and then I'm going to get back onto the 1350 Enterprise, get that started, wiring that up, and then we'll go from there. Maybe we'll get back onto the FX.
Right, so as I was saying, this is the downshot view. So hopefully, if we were, let's just get, so you said we get the Enterprise there, you'll be able to see what I'm working on. Won't be able to do zooming on this, we don't have to do that on this, I don't think you can, but at least you'll be able to see what I'm working on from above, so my hands and things aren't too much in the way. Yeah, I like this. I also use it in when I'm in some forums and some chat rooms with international scale modeler when he does his hangouts, live hangouts, etc. So yeah, let's just click back to the other camera.
Right, so that's a tour of my man cave, my modeling area, we would like to call it. We've all got our own names. One thing I didn't show is all the bits and pieces on top of the ceiling, but maybe I'll show that another time, maybe I'll have to see some of those later. So yeah, please like and subscribe my video. I'm just going to show you in a minute one of the cameras I showed about, the overhead camera, so you can see what stuff, sort of stuff, how easy it is to see what I'm going to be building with. Hopefully I'm going to be able to incorporate a lot more in my videos. Hope you've enjoyed this. Let's just try that, let's go back to that one second.